So 5G is something that's upcoming. 5G will be there in a few years, it'll be all over the place. LTE is something that's currently there and a lot of work is going on. As well as the important fact that 5G is not currently defined as such. Every key player has their own definition of 5G, how they are planning to pan out 5G.
Currently, we are creating a software level connection between Mac to Mac layer, which is between UE and InnoVie. Because since 5G is into making and there are plans of doing virtualization at the MME and EPC side, we are also trying to look into that part where we can create network slices and put our ENOTB code on the existing EPC infrastructure. So since the idea is about 5G protocol stack and we have to start somewhere, so we have existing release 8 code, and on top of that we are adding different functionalities that came over the duration of last 3 to 4 years, and we'll try to catch up with what is there in 5G now.
So we are working on this open source project in which we are trying to implement the LTE release 8 features in the in our example code files, and my work is towards the Mac-to-Mac tunneling, in which we are implementing the features of LTE release 8 in the ENOTB side and the UE side. So basically this project is helping me out in a way that, because the technical things and the features which I've learned in the theoretical part of the LTE, now I'm getting to implement in the network how it's being implemented for the users and all. What we're exactly doing is, at present we are we have the code available, example codes available, and we are just trying to, for this part of the semester, we are just trying to study these example codes and see how it's being implemented in the release 8 thing. And then we have studied the release 10 and their advancements in the LTE, which has already happened, and then we are moving towards 5G. So we want to understand the code, and then we want to reproduce the code for the next features. And I would like to thank Professor Ethmar for this. I've taken two of his courses. His initial 759 course is really good, in which he actually explains you all the LTE and WCD main GSM cases, and tells you how we have moved on from GSM to WCDMA and to LTE, and what all features have been implemented in that. And then we have this independent study which I have taken, and in which you are actually learning how we are moving from LTE release 8 to release 10, and what all new features have been added. Our basic layer will be the LTE. Now we will be implementing 5G only to have the more improve the capacity in the network. So if you have all the technical features and the new feature, latency improved features in the LTE, so that you can utilize the spectrum more efficiently.
So working in this forum gave me a very good opportunity to interact with, network with many seniors out in the ENTS department, ENTS program in the Telecommunications department. I could talk to them about various technologies that's in the market. I could get their experience working with companies, as most of them have interned with very good companies over the last summer, and then I could get a lot of information from them. So with 5G being released into the market within the next 4 to 5 years, I think this is the perfect time for us to work on this project currently, and then extend it to the cutting edge technologies that are going to be released in the future. So now currently we're planning to work on LTE standard 8, and then we're planning to extend it over the future when the next standards come in. And we are also planning to make this project open source so that anyone in the world can use it and work on it and develop their own cool stuff on it. Program in the area of telecommunications offered at the University of Maryland really helped me gain the basic concepts in the area of telecommunications and wireless technologies, which I'm able to apply in this forum. And the concepts that are being taught by Dr. Mercado and Dr. Delomo in the courses that I've currently taken so far were really helpful in taking me forward in this project and work on it. I really could apply the theoretical knowledge that I learned in the classes, and I could apply them while working in this forum.
So another aspect of this project, what we're looking at is developing a GUI
So what LTE has a lot of radio parameters which we can configure. So what we are trying to avoid is that the need for the user to actually go to the code and make changes to it. So when you have a GUI, you can just, you know, select the options that you want and you can, you know, work towards it. Instead of like going to wasting time with changing parameters, you can actually concentrate on what you actually want to do. So that is one thing that we are looking at. Another thing what we are doing is, I'm involved is in website development for our project. So in the website, we'll be giving a good overview about our project and then what sort of hardware are we working upon. And even we'll be giving a brief overview of the three aspects that we're looking at. Mainly GUI development, then we have Mac to Mac tunneling, and we have Python binding. So these aspects we'll be telling about in what ways we can contribute. So if any ENTS student is interested to come into the picture, then they can just look and, you know, find a point of contact and they can talk to, even look at the various members. If they know anyone, it's much easier that way. So they, rather than approaching one unknown person, because so they can just go talk to their friends, because we have both seniors and juniors in this project. Talk to your friends, get more involved in it, and at some point of time, if they feel that their experiences and what they have learned through coursework, they can contribute, they can come in at any point of time, and they can, you know, be on level with what we are doing as well.
So basically, we are working on Python binding for the existing code. So what we are working on is, like, we have a LTE code in C++ language, and since all of the program developers usually tend to move to Python language, we are trying to bind this C++ code into the Python. And at the end of the semester, we want to upload this onto the GitHub so that everybody has a public access to that, and work more on that. I've taken ENTS 653, which is a basic course on the communication standards. So I've been getting the history and overview of all the technologies that has been implemented till now. So it gives me a basic overview of how to work on these technologies, what is the major advantages, why we moved on to 3G to 4G to 5G, something like that. 689F, that's on the basic wireless LAN. So in that, I got to know about the frame structures, the MAC frame structures, how the communication happens, what are the different technologies like OFDM and other spreading techniques. So that helps in actually implementing this whole thing.
As a project lead, the role that we have is to manage the different teams that are there. So as we know, there are different parts of this project. It's a huge project, it's a huge staff. So there are different parts, and understanding each part cannot be done by a team lead as a whole. So as a project lead, what you can do is you can understand the upper level layers of these different parts, and then you can bring in your contributions. You can have an understanding at an upper level. The different people who are working, they can get much deeper into the project. And my key role in this project would be in the Mac-to-Mac tunneling. So currently we have 5-to-5 layer communication, and what we are trying to do is port it to a Mac level. So that is where my key role comes in, and I'll be managing the different other groups.
Project is open for all the ENTS students, and it will be a really good experience for them to have hands-on experience. If some students are only interested in the networking layer, then there is a upper layer stack which they can focus on. If people are interested into learning OFDM or how the resource allocation is being done, then we have a file layer, radio layer, where they can focus on. So this LTE is leading to 5G, which is amalgamation of different technologies, and whoever is interested in whatever aspect of telecommunication, they can join this team and they can try to get their hands dirty by running their code on their system.